Harry Adams is with me in the studio this morning from Argentex. Harry, good morning.
Morning.
Nice to see you. An important day for the business here. First day of dealings on AIM. Good response from investors?
Great response, yeah. Really happy with how it went.
And you raised how much through the IPO?
So we raised £12 million there.
Right. We'll come back to the cash and your plans in a moment, but tell me a bit more about the business.
So we are Argentex. So we predominantly deal for corporate businesses. So they can be SMEs. We can deal with the financial institutions, so a lot of private equity based. Really any company that's moving one currency to another, we'll give them recommendations and advice on when to do that, how to do that. And we'll also deal with a few private clients who have a lot of sportsmen and women, really giving the same sort of service. So sort of a proactive service that they're not able to get from the banks.
And are these predominantly UK businesses?
Yeah, about 75% of our business is UK. 25% is overseas, but realistically what we call overseas is probably a UK business that is administered out of Luxembourg, for example.
Right. Why did you feel now was the right time to come to the markets?
Well, I mean, we've looked at it over the last 12 months on when to come to the market, and it got to a stage where the demand was as such, we needed more money. So in order for us to trade, we have to basically put some money with a counterparty in order to take on a currency trade for one of our clients. The more demand means that we need more money,
right.
Simple as that.
And so that's where predominantly much of the 12 million net will go?
Pretty much all the capital, it will be going pretty much to lodge into collateral,
right.
Counterparties, yeah.
But you talk about the strong demand there for your services. What's driving that? Why do people turn to Argentex rather than like your competitors, Travelex?
Yeah, I think, we're in a space which is very different to the likes of Travelex, Western Union. We're looking at servicing clients that have an FX annual turnover of somewhere between a few million to a few hundred million. And really that's an area where the client requires a certain level of input. The sophistication level seems to be out of the reach of the Western Unions and the smaller retail brokers. And the banks are less interested in servicing those clients.
Mm-hmm. And so where do you see the opportunities for growth then?
Well, we're seeing that at the moment 85% of corporates still trade with their bank for their foreign exchange. So the market is absolutely huge. So it's not really about us and the non-bank 15%. It's trying to persuade that 85% to give the likes of Argentex a chance. And you know, there might be various reasons why people wouldn't want to give us a chance. So common objections might be safety of funds, for example, regulation. The fact that the money will be leaving their bank rather than, you know, if they were to trade with the bank, it will stay in one account and move to a euro account within that same bank. But slowly we're sort of trying to win around these clients and demonstrate that actually we are incredibly safe. We are belt and braces in terms of regulation and hopefully we tick all the boxes for compliance purposes.
So is there a certain marketing drive and educational roadshow, if you like, required?
Not really. I think we're very lucky. The fact that, first of all, every client will have experience with trading a bank. Sometimes that's good, sometimes that's bad. And really what we're here to do is kind of educate a client to say, you don't have to do all your trading with the bank. You can give someone like Argentex a go. And if it doesn't work out for you or we don't offer any value, then go back to your bank. You know, nothing gained, nothing lost.
Right. And you offer what you'd believe to be fairly competitive rates?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I think price is a bit of a red herring because we have to be giving a better price in order for clients to be trading with us in the first place. But it comes down to the service, the proactivity, the flexibility that we offer. Ultimately, it's not just a price war. We allow the smaller micropayments companies, you know, the TransferWise, the Revolutes, to have a race to the bottom on that end.
Mm. You've been around since when, 2011?
Argentex, yeah, was formed in 2011, yeah.
You're profitable?
We've been profitable every year since inception.
What are you putting that down to?
Well, initially putting it down to the fact that it was started by myself, my three other colleagues who knew the business incredibly well. And you know, being part of an LLP, we were always looking at profit rather than marketing expenses and turnover. You know, really, if we wanted to get paid, we needed to make a profit.
Given the climate at the moment with the likes of the US trade wars, Brexit, are you seeing some opportunities there for you?
Yeah, I mean, certainly we had a good March and put a lot of that down to the fact that we had the cliff edge and the clients were not forced, but they wanted to try and cover something just in case. So I think maybe, you know, March wasn't a fair representation of last year, although last year was very good. The difference between our clients and maybe the clients of the spread bettors or the speculators, which is not our business, is that our clients actually have to trade regardless of what happens in the market. So they have to buy their dollars to buy their 100,000 t-shirts in China, for example. They can't just wait for the price to rise to a certain level. They actively need to go into the market, buy these dollars, so their t-shirts can be delivered to the UK. Mm. So yeah, it will obviously help. Volatility is great, but it's certainly not a driver of our business.
Well, just from an investor's perspective then, what in particular should we be looking out for over the next year from you?
You know, we've delivered every year. We've been profitable since inception. We have a huge pipeline of business coming through, which is why we're getting this money now, getting ahead of the curve, so we're not on the point of turning away business, which we could easily be. So really it's more of the same. You know, we're not going to change anything. We're not going to start going after bigger business. We're not going to start pivoting into tech. We're just going to do more of the same and continuing to deliver on what we know we're good at.
Good to see you this morning, Harry. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.